Hey, it's Monday morning, and I'm Jack Lucas.
Hi. Hello. This is about my husband.
Yes.
Well, he drives me crazy. I'll be talking, and he'll never let me finish a sentence. Mm. He's always finishing.
He's always finishing your thoughts. That's awful.
It absolutely drives.
It drives you crazy, doesn't it? He's a scoundrel.
Jack, you've hit the nail.
Hit the nail on the head.
On the head.
Yeah, somebody ought to hit you on the head. So tell us, how long have you and Senator Payton been having this this sleazy affair?
Oh, great.
Hmm?
This is great. This is disgusting. I am so tired of the public thinking that they have got a right to invade a person's private life, okay?
Please, come on. You had sex with a United States senator in the parking lot of SeaWorld. You're telling me you're a private kind of person? No. You're our
spotlight celebrity!
We want to hear about the back seats of limos, sweetheart. About the ruined lives of people we want to be.
Oh.
New and exotic uses for champagne corks.
Listen, I have been humiliated enough already, okay?
No, perhaps not. We need those details.
You're a pig, Jack.
You're on the air, caller.
Hello, Jack. It's Edwin.
Oh, it's Edwin. Edwin, we haven't heard from you in what, a day? I've missed you.
I've missed you too, Jack.
So it's sunrise confession time, Ed. What have you got for us?
I went to this bar, this very, hard to get into place called Babbitt's.
Oh, yeah, I know the place. It's one of those chic, yuppie watering holes.
I met this beautiful woman.
Oh, come on now, Ed. If you start telling me you're falling in love again, I'm going to have to remind you of that time we made you propose to that checkout girl at Thrifty's that you like so much. Do you remember her reaction?
She was just a girl. Uh-huh. This is a beautiful woman.
Yeah, and Pinocchio is a true story. Ed, you're never going to get this tart to your dessert plate.
No, this is different.
Edwin.
She likes
me. Edwin. Hey, Edwin! Hey, come on now. I told you about these people. They only mate with their own kind. It's called yuppie inbreeding. That's why so many of them are retarded and wear the same clothes. They're not human. They don't feel love. They only negotiate love moments. They're evil, Edwin. They're repulsed by imperfection, horrified by the banal, everything that America stands for, everything that you and I fight for. They must be stopped before it's too late. It's us or them.
Okay, Jack.
All right. Well, it's been a thrill. As always, have a perfect day. Everyone here at the Jack Lucas Show says bye.
Bye, Jack.
This is Jack Lucas. So long, arrivederci. I'll be sending you a thought today as I lie in the back of my stretch limo having sex with a teenager of my choice. And that thought will be, thank God I'm me.
Some of this is very funny. Cheever told me they even secured the rights to the Donna Summer song to play over the credits.
Ooh, I have chills. You sure they want me? I'm not going to read it unless I have an offer.
Jeff, of course, not even a question. When I talked to him on the phone this morning, I could smell how much they want you for it. I could smell it over the phone. Oop, bums. I don't have any change yet.
I'm not opening this window. A couple of quarters isn't going to make any difference anyway. My cheeks.
Raul called before about dinner.
Yeah. About dinner as a concept or about dinner with Raul?
You're so witty. I gotta get out of here, Jack, and do something.
You know, tomorrow is a very big day for me. It would be nice if you pretended like you understood.
Fine. I'll say no.
They're putting me on film tomorrow.
Fine.
First time in my life, I'll be a voice with a body. You know what that means? What this could lead to?
It's a sitcom, Jack. You're not defining pie.
I'll remember that the next time you get excited by drawing pubic hair on Raisin Bran. You want some?
No, I have to work.
How old in the 60s have you?
I was 9 in the 60s.
I used to think my biography ought to be entitled Jack Lucas, the face behind the voice. And now it can be Jack Lucas, the face and the voice. Or maybe just Jack! Exclamation point. Honey! Where's my orange cup with the teddy bear? I'll kill that old bitch. I have a fever. I really think I'm dying. Well, forgive me. Hey. Forgive me. Forgive me. Forgive me. Hey. Forgive me. Forgive me. Hey, forgive me. Yeah. Horrified by the banal, everything that America stands for, everything that you and I fight for, Edwin. They must be stopped before it's too late. It's us or them.
It was Mr. Lucas's offhand remark that seemed to have fatal impact on Mr. Melnick. Mark Saffron is on the scene.
An after-work hotspot, Babbitt's is popular with single young professionals. Edwin Melnick arrived at the peak hour of 7:15, took one long look at the handsome collection of the city's best and brightest, then removed a shotgun from his overcoat and opened fire. 7 people were killed before Mr. Melnick turned the gun on himself and shot a hole through his head. Representatives of radio cult personality Jack Lucas expressed regret. However, no formal comment has been made. Neighbors of Melnick said he was a quiet man who lived alone. He scarcely knew he was there, said a woman who lived next door to Melnick for 11 years. But today, few will soon forget this lonely man who reached out to a world he knew only through the radio, looking for friendship and finding only pain and tragedy. Mark Saffron, Channel 7 News.
Fuck. Pigs. Go right ahead. Right ahead.
Hey, who's the happiness?
Yeah.
Are you gonna do a little work today or what?
What, out there?
They're not terrorists, Jack. They're just ordinary people like you and me.
Breakfast of champions, right?
Excuse me, can you help me? I'm at an absolute loss. I've been looking for over an hour and I'm losing my mind. What I'm in the mood for is sort of a Katherine Hepburn-y Cary Granty kind of thing. Nothing heavy. I couldn't take heavy. No, something zany. I'm looking for something zany. Or something modern would be fine too, like a Goldie Hawn Chevy Chasey kind of thing. You know, funny. I want to laugh. I have to laugh tonight, really. Oh, do you have anything with that comedian? He's on that show. It's on the radio. You know the guy, he says, hey, forgive me. I get such a kick out of the way he says that. He's so goddamn adorable. That would be perfect. Didn't he make a movie? Ordinary Peoples.
It's kind of a big titty, spread cheeky kind of thing.
Excuse me, I just want to borrow him for a minute.
You're gonna love that. That was a frightening moment.
Are you in one of your moods today, baby?
She didn't get something zany real quick.
Yeah, yeah. Is this one of the days when you're in your, what do you call that thing, your emotional abyss? Can you explain this to me, baby? Because I don't understand these moods that you get into.
And they're my moods. You would understand moods have one of your own, okay? I hate desperate people.
Sweetie, baby, love of my life, you hate people. Look, why don't you take the day off? Go upstairs, put your feet up. I'll cook tonight, okay?
Good night.
Honey, have you seen my orange cup with a teddy bear?
Grandma used it for her urine specimen.
Dividing up my estate. I gotta go hide my trophy cups in case Grandma finds herself at a beer hall put.
Well, it's funny. What do you want from me?
It's not funny.
Then why do we watch it all the time?
Because it makes me feel good to see how not funny it is. Now, America doesn't know the first thing about funny, which makes it easier not being a famous funny TV celebrity, because that would just mean I'm not really talented.
You are a sick fuck, you know that? You know, I don't know why you torture yourself. Dude, you do that. I don't like that.
I'm trying to watch.
You have too many thoughts rolling around up there. You're very self-absorbed, Jack. God, divert yourself. My God, read a book.
It's important to think, Anne. It's what separates us from lentils and people that read books like Love Song.
Great book, dumb title. You know, you used to say that you liked that about me. You used to say you liked that we didn't have to think all the time, that we could just be together and not think.
Suicidal paranoics will say anything to get laid.
Have another drink, Jack. It's on the house, like everything else.
I hope when you get to be my age, your children treat you with the same disrespect. I got a fever. I'm dying. I'm a dead man.
You're not dying. You just have a cold. And besides, you can't die before Sunday because we have to go to the Billy Joel concert.
Ah, well, forgive me!
Madness. Fuck.
help a guy out. Help me out with a quarter. Come on. Sport. Sport.
Hey, I told you, Yankee. Come on. What's the matter with you? What's going on? Get away from me. Get away from me. You're a maniac. You're crazy.
Mr. Baum.
Come in.
Here.
Hey, anybody here named Jiminy? Jibberini Nietzsche. Nietzsche says there are two kinds of people in the world. People who are destined for greatness, like Walt Disney and Hitler. And then there's the rest of us. Called us the bungled and the botched. We get teased. We sometimes get close to greatness, but we never get there. We're the expendable masses. We get pushed in front of trains, take poison aspirin, get gunned down and Dairy Queens. You want to hear the new title of my biography? My little Italian friend. There's no fucking picnic. The Jack Lucas story. You like it? Il nuovo est fucking picnico. You're a good kid. You say no to drugs. You ever get the feeling sometimes you've been punished for your sins?
City squires like you abusing a night like this.
Are you a faggot too?
Faggot? No, but I do believe in fairy.
Not without dinner.
You fucking nuts. Viola! The charm is won!
I have to advise you to let us go.
Oh, you advise us, huh?
Yes. You're outnumbered, son.
And look at me.
Looks like Night of the Living Dead.
Come on. Go for it. They can't do nothing.
Can't do nothing. Can't do nothing.
Nothing. Gentlemen.
I like New York in June.
How about you?
I like a Gershwin tune. How about you?
Oh, look, it's showtime. You know, boys, there's three things in this world that you need. Respect for all kinds of life, a nice ball movement on a regular basis, and a navy blazer. Oh, one more thing. Never take your eye off the ball.
Look, the ability to being a shithead can be a fabulous advantage.
Hey! Don't hurt me.
Hey, why, so you can be healthy when you jump? No.
You can't let me tie up out here alone, you fucking faggot!
Oh, you're not gonna be alone, huh? Hey-o. Come and get it!
I need a drink.
Hey, I know a fabulous place with great ambiance.
So what do you think of the death penalty, man?
Death's definitely a penalty. Ain't no fucking gift. Life's too goddamn short.
Great place, huh?
How are you tonight?
Not bad, John. And you?
Can't complain.
Can I interest anybody in a fruit pie, huh?
No, thank you. Too fast. So sweet.
You.
I like the orchestra.
How about you?
You're great tonight, Jerry.
I like the painted moonlight. How about you?
Hi. Welcome back. How are you feeling?
Have I died?
Oh, no.
Hey, easy. Easy, you want to get up? There you go. Hey, gravity works. Come on, take it real slow. There you go. Take a few breaths, huh? There you are.
Where am I?
It's my domicile. My humble abode.
Mi casa, su casa.
Oh, you want something to eat? Because your stomach must be a real tabla rasa after last night. If these are raisins or rat shit, you can't tell sometimes.
Oh, yeah. How about a fruit pie?
You're right about that one. I was off by a couple of months.
Nice to have company. Hi.
Where are my shoes?
What?
Where?
What?
What?
Shh. What is it? I knew it last night. I did too. I did. Don't look at me. Don't. He's the one. Can you keep a secret?
No.
Good. Because you know what the little people told me?
The little people?
Oh,
You know.
They said, you're the one.
The one what?
Shut up! Get away from him! Oh, this will get window through your
face. I'm sorry about this. It'll be good.
Oh, there we are. Yeah. They said you're not ready to know yet.
I'm not.
He is too! Get out of here! Fuck off!
Oh, be it! Oh, I have rights! Oh, yeah, fly up there. Oh, yeah.
Move out. Come on, out of here.
Hey! You can't be in there.
You're frightening him.
Do you know who I am?
I'm drawing a blank.
Well, take a guess. Let him guess.
I don't know, you seem to be some kind of vigilante.
Well, that happens along the way, of course. Here's a clue.
A hood ornament.
No. I'm a knight on a special quest. And I need help.
Quest.
That's why they sent you.
The little...
Yes, yes. You see, they work for him. So do I.
Him?
God. I'm the janitor of God. I know.
Yeah. Hey, I know how you feel. I mean, they came to me about a year ago. I was sitting on the john, having one of those really satisfying bowel movements. You know those ones that border on mystical, where you're like...
There they were. Hundreds of the cutest little fat people floating right in front of me. It was wonderful. And then they spoke. And they said that I had been chosen to get back something very special that he had lost. It might probably be very dangerous. I said, whoa! Hold it right there. I mean, you start seeing floating little fat people tell you that you're on a mission from God.
They'll slap you some heavy thorazine.
I said, give me a sign. And they said, look in Progressive Architecture. February 88, page 33. That's pretty specific, huh?
Bingo. He knows. He knows. It's right here. Where is it? A, B, F, F, M, M, M.
It's under miscellaneous, not mythology.
Look at this. Here it is. See it?
Mm-hmm. Langdon Carmichael.
No, right there. See it?
What?
The Grail. The Holy Grail. It's God's symbol of divine grace.
The Holy... Yes. Some billionaire has got the Holy Grail in his library on Fifth Avenue.
My thoughts exactly. Look if you find anything divine on the Upper East Side.
Listen, I don't mean to be flippant or enrage you or anything, but you're a psychotic man.
I know.
A very nice psychotic man. Oh. I appreciate what you did. I think it was a brave and noble thing.
Oh, stop embarrassing me.
I'm gonna see a lot of you on various talk shows when you get the Grail. I'm just...
Please, don't go.
I can't. I can't get it. Because he's out there.
He's always down there.
That's why you can get it. That's why you're the one.
Not the one. I'm not anyone. Forget about the shoes. I'm gonna take a cab.
Perry,
I'm Jack.
I know.
Oh, wait! Here they are. Jack.
It works.
You can keep them all.
Hey, thanks a mil, huh? Hey, now that you know where we are, don't be a stranger. Come back, we'll rummage. Take care of yourself, Jack. Give my love to the wife, huh?
I'm not married.
Really? You look married. Don't be a stranger. See ya.
Hey, where you coming from?
The basement, I think.
I tell him no business! Hey, hold it.
Huh?
Listen, you a friend of Perry's?
No.
Well, I don't allow no entertaining. Look, I let him stay here out of the goodness of my heart because of the tragedy. But I'm not running a hotel, and nobody's taking advantage of me.
Tragedy?
He and his wife were in some bar, and some nut comes in with a shotgun and blew the place apart. Splattered her brains all over the walls. She was a beautiful girl. Never knew what hit her. You ought to heard about that nut who listened to the radio.
You could have been attacked, you could have been raped, God knows what. I was up all night long, Jack.
Sorry.
Yeah?
Guy wants to check out the pornos.
So send him back. What the hell happened?
I was attacked.
What? Oh, baby.
Two kids tried to set me on fire.
Oh, my God. What? Ow. What did they do to you, baby? Almost done?
So
what are you
many,
looking for? You looking for a story? What?
I've seen them. They're most of them.
Here, Crema versus Crema. Won an award. Go. Did you call the police? Do you want me to call the doctor? Tell me what you want. Are you sure? So where did you sleep last night?
I stayed at a friend's, Anne.
Okay, Jack, I want you to be upfront with me now. If you're seeing somebody else, just tell me. You don't have to pour gasoline all over yourself and light a match just to break up with me here. Just tell me the truth.
Anne, I was not seeing anyone else. I really was attacked.
Okay.
I've got a cut here.
Okay, I see it now. I'm sorry. I love you. What are you gonna do? You don't have to say it back.
Although it wouldn't break your joy to try.
You know what the Holy Grail is?
Holy Grail? Yeah, I know that one. That was like Jesus juice glass. Oh, yeah, I used to be such a Catholic.
You still believe in God?
You gotta believe in God. But I don't believe that God made men in his image. Because most of the shit that happens is because of men. Now, I think man was made in the devil's image, and women were created out of God. Because after all, women can have babies, which is kind of like creating. And which also counts for the fact that women are so attracted to men. Because let's face it, the devil is a hell of a lot more interesting. I slept with some saints in my day, and believe me, I know what I'm talking about. Boring.
So, the whole point of life, I
think is for men and women to get married so that God and the devil can get together and work it out. Not that we have to get married or anything. God forbid.
We have a little thing right here.
What, a pimple? Oh, yeah, this stuff is supposed to blend with my skin like it really works, you know?
No, I don't think I'm up for it tonight, honey. I just had a very traumatic experience. I'm getting sick. Ow, 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 ow.
Careful now.
And I spent the night in a boiler room. I'm tired. Oh, I'm upset. I'm not in the mood, okay? Can I help you? I was looking for Perry.
He's not here. The hospital said it would be best if we kept certain things away from him. There, now there's his real name, Henry Sagan. He was a teacher over at Hunter College. They kept him in a mental place over on Staten Island. He did not speak for a year, and then all of a sudden he started talking. Only now he's this Perry guy. He and his wife used to live upstairs. When he got released, they sent him here. I felt bad. He couldn't work. Nobody wanted him. So I let him stay in the basement. He helped out. I'd give him a couple of dollars. People throw things away, he gets them. She was a beautiful girl. He was crazy about her.
I appreciate the way you deal with people. I really do. I'm a big fan.
Well, good. I enjoy appreciating it.
Listen, I especially appreciated the other day when you told that homeless schmuck, who do you think he is talking about the money that you made?
Yeah, well, I got it.
Who is he to ask Jack Lucas anything?
What's the matter, baby? Can't sleep?
I'll tell you something, man. I really feel cursed.
Stop it. Things will change.
I feel like I'm a magnet, but I attract shit. Out of all the people in this city, why did I meet a man whose wife I killed?
You didn't kill anybody. Stop it.
I wish there was some way I could just pay the fine and go home.
Hi, Jack.
Thought maybe you could use a couple of...
Isn't she a vision?
Yeah, gorgeous. Look, I just wanted to.
Look.
Hey, look. I'm leaving. I'm going. I just wanted to give you.
Dumplings.
Yeah.
That's the Wednesday ritual. Oh, it's so sweet. But she does that every time. Oh.
We're looking through the window. You got a problem with that, buddy? I'm looking through the fucking window.
Jack. Told me I'd be in love with a girl who chews jawbreakers, I'd say they're nuts. But look at that jaw. Oh. There she goes.
Oh, you follow her every day, huh?
Oh, it's not like that. I'm deeply smitten.
Who is she? What's her name?
I don't know. A cooler! Oh, this beautiful needs a little work.
Here,
what?
I just would like to help you.
$50.
All right. Here, look. Here's another 20. Will that do it?
$70.
How much is this gonna take?
You're so nice, Jack. I don't know what.
Oh, Jack. Oh, that's okay.
Hey, can I take you to lunch? Huh?
No, I gotta go back to work. Take care of yourself.
pit. Bye! Bye!
Fuck them all!
Hold it, bastard!
What are you doing? Give him that back!
Hey, Jack!
Jack! What are you doing?
Jack, let go!
Let go! What are you doing? What the fuck are you doing?
Jack, what did you do that?
I gave that to you!
What am I gonna do?
I don't know, but I gave it to you to help you, not to help him!
Jack, you really want to help me?
Okay, you can open your eyes. Pretty impressive, huh? Oh, don't let it scare you. As formidable as it seems, everything has its weakness.
Hey, at least there's no moat.
You can't just break into Langdon Carmichael's house. This man's done nothing.
Hey! I'll deal with it. Jack, let's go through this one more time, okay?
Look, please, listen
there
to me.
There is the Holy Grail in...
Listen to me. Don't start drooling or rolling your eyes when I tell you this. But you shouldn't be doing this. There is no Holy Grail.
Oh, Jack, ye of little faith. Jack, there has to be a grail. What were the Crusades? A Pope's publicity stunt? Oh, you heathen. There's a grail.
Hey, wait, look, wait a minute. Look.
Hey!
You're only partly insane. People like you can lead semi-normal lives. You can get a job.
I have a job, Jack. I have a quest.
I take it back. You're fucking deranged. You're gonna get yourself killed trying to get in there.
That's so sweet. Now I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to protect me, aren't you? You think there's danger in there.
No. I think you're a moron, and I don't want to get in trouble.
You care. First the money, now this. Oh, that's so sweet. Oh, you fabulous guy.
Don't hug me in public again, okay?
Oh, men with men. Oh, Jack, I love this guy! You hear me? I love this guy! Oh, you hear me, Jaded City? I love Jack! He cares! Oh, Jack! And this jaded motherfucking city that you...
Will you shut up?
Oh, you hear me? I'm loopy about this guy! Oh, Jack! Oh, you're a real human being! Oh, you're a friend. A true friend.
I'm not. Believe me. You're scum.
Come on. I'm not gonna listen. You're an honest-to-goodness good guy.
Self-centered, I'm weak. I don't have the willpower of a fly on shit.
Yeah, but that's why little people sent you. They knew that. It's like magic.
I don't believe in little floating people, okay? There is no magic.
But you're still gonna help me, Jack. That's what matters.
Perry. Perry, or whatever your name Jack. Is. You know none of this is true. The grail, the voices. Jack, there's a part of you that knows it's not true.
I think we have to start planning now.
Harry, Jack. Listen to me.
Jack. You're acting weird, Jack.
I know who you are. You're an
intelligent... Jack! Let go of me! Let go of me, Jack!
Undercover.
No!
Harry!
No!
You're a teacher!
No!
Harry!
Thank you. I'm dying. I can't breathe.
Isn't this a beautiful spot, Jack?
Who have we been chasing? Can I ask this question now?
He's gone now. We had him on the run, didn't we? If we had horses, we'd have had his ass. Oh, boy.
Who?
What?
Who have we been chasing?
Jack, I thought you saw him.
Saw who?
The Red Knight.
Okay. I gave you the money. You want to keep it? Fine. You want to give it away? Fine. I just want you to know I did give him the money, okay? Are we clear?
Who are you talking to, Jack? Be praised in giving so soon an opportunity for me to fulfill the duties of my profession. These cries doubtless proceed from some miserable male or female in need of my immediate aid and protection.
This is too hard.
Come on, let me help you up.
No, I want a debutante on the horse to step on me.
Harry.
Please leave me alone. Hey,
sorry to tell you this, but the days of debutantes are over.
Isn't it awful? Poor little Gloria. Poor Brenda Fraser. They ruined them. They ate them alive.
Yeah, but what about Slim Keith, that little Guggenheim girl?
Imposters! Leave me alone.
Jack, come on, lend a hand.
Listen, he just needs to sleep it off. Somebody will take care of him. Come
Who?
On.
Mother Teresa? She's retired. Come on, it's just us. Let's go.
Maybe he wants to stay here. You want to stay here?
Oh, yeah, sure. I'll just love bleeding and horse shit. How very Gandhi-esque of you.
Jack?
Get out of the way!
Please, I was born in a place like this. I don't want to be here. Please,
come on.
Please.
Dr. Morris,
please.
Take care of
us. No. I want to go. Please, let me go.
Where do you want to go?
This is a nice place that I know about. All
right. Well, maybe we can go there later.
We can't go there tonight.
Well, maybe we can. Where do I go?
We can. No.
Where do you want to go?
Venice. Like Katherine Hepburn in Summertime. Why can't I be Katherine Hepburn? I want to die. I just want to be
Oh, that's it. Okay, ready? I like New York in June. I'm in the wrong place. Are we all? I like a Gershwin tune. Don't hold back. Okay. I like to read good books.
How am I going to do it? The children, where are going to put them? Goddamn daughter-in-law comes in the house looking for dust balls. Get the fuck out of my dining room, you asshole.
That's wonderful feeling, but you're stretching. Come on, tempo, allegro, people, allegro.
Okay.
When you... Did you lose your mind all of a sudden, or was it a slow, gradual process?
Well, I'm a singer by trade. Summer stock nightclub reviews, that sort of thing. And God, I absolutely live for it. I can do gypsy. every part. I can do it backwards. But then one night, right in the middle of singing, funny, suddenly it hit me. What does all this mean? I mean, that plus the fact that I'd watched all my friends die. Sound like a veteran, don't I? My dad would be so proud of me.
Hey.
Pizza! Now about time.
Never gonna find her in this crowd.
She's like clockwork, Jack. She comes through here at the same time every day. She's late. Thank you.
Barry?
Did you hear Jimmy Nichols got picked up yesterday?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. He got caught pissing on a bookstore. Man's a pig. No excuse for that. Thank you, babe. We're headed for social anarchy when people start pissing on bookstores.
Asshole.
Didn't even look at you.
Well, he's paying so we don't have to look. See, guy goes to work every day, 8 hours a day, 7 days a week. He gets his nuts so tight in a vice that he starts questioning the very fabric of his existence. And then one day, about quitting time, boss calls him into the office and says, "Hey, Bob, why don't you come on in here and kiss my ass for me, will you?" Well, he says, "Hell with it. I don't care what happens. I just want to see the expression on his face as I jam this pair of scissors into his arm." Then he thinks of me. He says, "Wait a minute. I got both my arms, I got both my legs. At least I'm not begging for a living." Sure enough, Bob's gonna put those scissors down and pucker right up. See, I'm what you call kind of a moral traffic light, really. I'm like saying, "Red, go no further."
Boop, 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 boop.
Thank you.
I do not need this. A woman my age? I'm a person. There's a person here. This is kid stuff. You come, you go. All I do is cook like a jerk. You waste a good lasagna. I don't need this. Find yourself another dope. Son of a bitch.
God, what a beautiful night, Jack.
Hey. You think it's time to go now? Running around here during the day is one thing, but at night we could be killed by a wide variety of people.
That's stupid, Jack. I mean, this park is mine just as much as it is theirs. I mean, do you think it's fair that they can keep us out? Because it just make us think that we might get killed or something?
Yes, I think it's very fair.
Well, I don't.
What are you doing?
I'm cloud busting, Jack. You ever done it? You lie on your back, and you concentrate on the clouds, and you break them apart with your mind. It's wild. No, but you have to be nude, though, Jack.
You can't do
this. Because you can't diffuse
this.
The psychic energy.
This is New York. No one's allowed to be naked in the field in New York. It's too Midwestern.
Well, come on, Jack. It's wild. It's really freeing.
What?
I mean, the air on your body, your nipples are hard, little guy dangling in the wind.
Hey, come on.
Oh, come on, Jack. What are
you pissing me off. Hey.
And we're bare-ass naked in the middle of it.
I'm not doing this. This is nuts. I'm leaving.
Jack, free yourself. Free yourself.
I'm
you know
leaving.
Why dogs do this? Yo, because it feels good, Jack.
I'm not doing that.
Yes. Yo.
Let it out.
Come on, Jack. Get back to your roots.
And the man talks to invisible people. He sees invisible horses. And he's lying naked in the middle of Central Park. I should be surprised. I'm not surprised. I'm out of my fucking mind to even be here.
Who are you talking to, Jack?
I'm talking to the little people.
Are they here?
They're saying, Jack, go to the nearest liquor store, find it the Jack of Daniels, that ye may be shit-faced. Dulang, Dulang!
They said that?
You're out of your fucking mind.
Bingo. Yell. Come on, Jack. Free up the little guy. Let him flap in the breeze. Yo, yo, papuna. Oh, Jack.
Nothing's happening.
Concentrate.
What if some homophobic jogger runs by and kills us to get back to his father? Jack Lucas, found dead next to a dead naked man. The two were dead, his companion was naked. I hate it when they use the word companion, it's so insinuating. Probably boosts the sales of my biography, though. The public has a fascination with celebrity murders that involve nakedness, bastards.
Jack, I may be going out on a limb here, but you don't seem like a happy camper. Did you ever hear the story of the Fisher King?
No.
Begins with the king as a boy. Having to spend the night alone in the forest to prove his courage so he can become king. And while he's spending that alone, he's visited by a sacred vision. Out of the fire appears the Holy Grail, symbol of God's divine grace. And a voice said to the boy, "You shall be keeper of the Grail so that it may heal the hearts of men." The boy was blinded by greater visions of a life filled with power and glory and beauty. And in this state of radical amazement, he felt for a brief moment not like a boy, but invincible, like God. So he reached in the fire to take the Grail, and the Grail vanished, leaving him with his hand in the fire to be terribly wounded. Now, as this boy grew older, his wound grew deeper. Until one day, life for him lost its reason.
He had no faith in any man, not even himself. He couldn't love or feel loved. He was sick with experience. He began to die. One day, a fool wandered into the castle and found the king alone. Now, being a fool, he was simple-minded. He didn't see a king. He only saw a man alone and in pain. And he asked the king, "What ails you, friend?" The king replied, "I'm thirsty. I need some water to cool my throat." So the fool took a cup from beside his bed, filled it with water, and handed it to the king. As the king began to drink, he realized his wound was healed. He looked in his hands, and there was the Holy Grail, that which he sought all of his life. He turned to the fool and said with amazement, "How could you find that which my brightest and bravest could not?" The fool replied, "I don't know. I only knew that you were thirsty." It's very beautiful, isn't it? I think I heard that at a lecture once. I don't know. It's professors. It's at Hunt.
You never asked that girl for a date, huh?
I can't ask her. I have to earn her, Jack.
Oh, come on now. This is the 20th century. You don't have to earn a woman.
Well, maybe after we get the Grail.
No, but see, she could help you get the Grail. You know, I mean, women are great. You know, they make homes, and they kill the livestock so the knights can go out there and get Grails. And slaughter villages with a clear head, huh? I mean, where would King Arthur be without Guinevere, huh?
Happily married, probably.
Well, that's a bad example. But trust me on this: a woman who loves you keeps you going, gives you strength, you know, makes you feel like you can do anything.
Is that what your girlfriend does for you?
Sure. Yeah. Publishing? Can I speak to Lydia, please?
Lydia? Who is Lydia?
No, I don't know her last name. I'll be off
you
in a second.
You're calling Lydia from my apartment? You
no.
must think
what?
I am some kind
no.
of dope, you son
I,
of
I
a bitch.
Her name is
all
Lydia.
All night long, I don't
Lydia.
Get a freaking phone call.
Hey,
you're
hey.
Calling here at noon. I got two people out sick.
Oh, hey.
You think I need this? I don't need
Lydia.
This.
No.
No.
Oh, shit. I was not out with a woman last night. I was out with Perry.
The moron?
He's not a moron.
Who's Lydia?
Lydia is the girl that Perry likes. I thought...
What? What did you think?
You wouldn't understand.
Don't talk to me like I'm stupid. That pisses me off.
Okay, okay. All right, I'm sorry. I feel indebted to the guy, okay?
What does that mean?
Here, you see?
Well, what does it mean?
I thought that if I could help him in some way, get him this this girl that he loves, that maybe, you know, things would change for me. Forget it, it's a dumb fuck.
You big galoot, you are such a mess. Well, listen. Stranger things have been known to happen.
Hello, Lydia. Lydia, this is Jack Lucas. I'm calling from Video Spot Video Rentals. And Lydia, you are a major credit card holder, are you not? Well, Lydia, I've got some good news for you. Out of several thousand credit card holders, in conjunction with several major credit card companies...
Which ones?
All of them. Which means that you have just won a free membership at our store.
How did this happen? My name was... Is my name on a list? Did you pick it out of a hat?
That's right. What? It was a list.
What, were there a lot of people in the room? Or just you?
There were... What's the difference?
Because I don't... I've never won anything in my life, and I don't even have a VCR, and I don't...
You're gonna get a free VCR with a membership, Lydia, for a short period of time until you get one of your own. Listen, I'll tell you, why don't you come on down to the store, check it out, see if you're interested.
No, did Phyllis tell you to call me and... Did Phyllis in accounting do that?
No, I told you. You won a contest. This is gonna be rough. It's gonna be rough.
I need to warm up.
I'm Admiral Lindbergh. I can't find my baby. I knew I could make you smile.
All right, come on. Look, one chorus, and then you're out of there.
Jack, okay? I'm a man with a mission.
Can't believe I'm on a first-name basis with these people.
Can I help you?
Is there a mousy little woman named Lydia who works here?
Yes. If you wait here, I'll get her on the
phone. Oh, no, it's a personalized message. I have to give it to her.
You can't go back there. You're really not allowed to go.
Lydia Sinclair.
You must be she.
I had a dream. A dream for guess who, Lydia. It wasn't for her, Lydia. It's only for you, yes, Lydia. Some people can get their kicks Watching couple and late night flicks. That's okay for some people who don't own VCRs. But Lydia, you've won the grand prize. Just think of it. All the movies you'll watch for free now. Dramas, westerns, comedies, wow! Video Spot has the best selection. If you like porno, we're your connection. And everything's coming up videos. Everything's coming up videos. But this time for free. For you, Lydia. For free.
Like you work here.
Well, what am I qualified to do?
Sort.
Yeah, this will be good. It'll make you smell like a forest. Oh, hi. How you doing? Congratulations, Jack Lucas. Nice to finally meet you. This is Ann Napolitano, the Video Spot owner.
Hello. Congratulations.
And this is our co-worker, Perry. Perry.
Perry, Perry.
No, just Perry.
Oh, like Moses. So how do we do this?
Well, first we'll have you sign out an official membership card there. Sign that if you would. We'll have that laminated for you right here. Perry, would you like to laminate Miss Sinclair's card?
Oh, yeah.
This will last you for a year, after which you have the option to renew, if you wish, at a membership discount.
Yeah, but not for free, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you get 10 videos.
Free?
Free.
Yeah, only the first 10. After that, they're $2.99 a rent.
Okay. Come on. Can I help you?
No, I can help myself.
Okay. Merchants. Good choice.
I don't like horror movies.
How about the Purple Bread? It's a big new Spatex film. It's set against a sweeping background of a Polish bakery. Polish! That's Polish bakery. That's why it's in subtitles.
Don't like love. Polish love stories. I like musicals.
Musicals. Over here. Oh, here's our entertainment center. We have, here's Fred Astaire. That's good. Yeah, Jolson, maybe. They have, and oh.
Got any Ethel Merman?
Ethel Merman. Oh, she's. Merman.
We're all out of Ethel Merman.
Oh! What a gypsy.
That sucks.
I think I actually ordered some just the other day.
Well, did you or didn't you?
Yeah, they'll be in soon.
Well, I'll come back then.
I'm missing Claire. Your card. Don't forget it.
I like your nails. Where'd you get them done?
Actually, I do them myself. I used to work in a beauty parlor.
I like the stars.
You know, Anne does other people. Sort of as a sideline, she could do your nails.
How much?
Well, you're a member. We could probably work
$40.
$40.
Okay. When will you do them?
I don't know. Next.
Tonight?
Tonight.
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 Thank you.
You know, Jack, getting your nails done is one thing, but going out to dinner with a bunch of strangers, and that one...
It's very casual.
She didn't even look at him.
It won't be like a date.
You got any more starchy food? Have
this. Good. Oh,
clumsy moi. Thank you.
I mean, I got out with some bums in my day, but they were beautiful. That is the only reason to go out with the bum.
This food is delicious, Anne. Really. I mean, you're a wonderful cook, and you have a great set of dishes.
Jack, he's trying to start a conversation.
Well, talk to him. He's not going to bite you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You know, you are a beautiful woman. You've got your own business. I am surprised some guy doesn't just snatch you up all for his own.
Oh, you're surprised? Because I just never met the right guy. What are you going to do?
No. I'm shocked. I mean, a childbearing body like yours. Well, I mean, a guy would have to be out of his mind.
Most guys are.
No. You, this incredible woman, going to waste before my very eyes? No, this is outrageous! I will not hear this. No! No, come on!
Jack,
come on.
Here.
I am your man, then. Let's do it right here. Let's go to that place of splendor in the grass.
Jack.
Behold my magic wand and free your golden orb
Jack,
right now.
Get over here.
You know what I'm saying, yes?
Are you?
Holding
are you?
My penis.
Out of your mind.
What a wonderful
close
way
up,
of
Jack.
Saying
Jack.
How much you
come
like.
On, Perry, close your pants.
Took
come
you
on.
Long enough, huh?
What are you, about a 40 in a jacket?
Yeah, that's it.
This is gonna work.
You let me know. Because you're too good a woman to go to waste.
Above a store before. You always walk past them on the streets when you walk by, but you never really think anyone really lives in them. get you something? A little coffee? A little tea?
No.
A little tequila?
No. Will it hurt?
That all depends on you. You sure you don't want a drink?
Let's enjoy this, boy. This is mud.
We just washed that off.
Now this is gonna make you look great.
Mm-hmm. It's good mud.
Clothes.
Mm-hmm.
Lips.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Clothes.
What are you doing?
Hmm? There we go. Now, you just relax.
So, anybody special in your life?
Does it look like there's anybody special in my life?
You don't have to say it like that. It's not so, you know, crazy an idea. You're a healthy woman, you have a steady job, you're not cross-eyed or anything.
No, there is nobody special. Okay, fine. I mean, it's not easy in this day and age.
What's not easy?
Meeting people.
Oh, God, tell me about it. I've been dating longer than I've been driving. I can't believe that.
Been through a dating period.
It's a disgusting process. You haven't missed a thing.
Well, still.
So excited. I mean, how do you feel like this when you first met Anne, huh? I mean, because she's a wonderful woman. I mean, she loves you too much, Jack. Bob, but you love her too, don't you? I mean, you know you do. It's just that you're a little bit of an asshole sometimes. Sorry.
My mother calls me once a week like an ongoing nightmare. So have you met anyone, though, Mom? So what's going to happen? I don't know, Mom. Thank God I moved out of that house.
I cannot believe that you lived with her as long as you did. If I had to live with my mother, I would stab myself 6 times.
I think some people are meant to be alone. This is my idea, that I was born a man in a former life, and I used women for pleasure. So now, I'm paying for it. I wouldn't mind so much if I could just remember the pleasure parts.
I think you're getting a little too complicated. What, in your opinion, is the actual problem?
I don't make an impression on people. At office parties, I rearrange the hors d'oeuvres while people are eating them so that the platters will remain full. I never start any of the conversations because I just don't know. I don't know where to make it end, to go.
Well, then listen. You gotta be a little easier on yourself, doll. A conversation has a life of its own, you know? You have to have some faith in that fact. I mean, look at us. We're having a very lovely conversation.
I'm paying you.
Oh, look, will you stop it? I'm not like that. I don't do people favors. If I talk to you, it's because I want to talk to you. All right, you're not a supermodel. We can't all be Jerry Hall. What a boring world it would be if we were all Jerry Hall.
Mm-hmm.
You do the best you can with what you got.
Mm.
You're not so invisible. Hey, you want a personality? Try this on for size. You can be a real bitch.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm gonna give you my wallet so you can pay for dinner, okay?
You're a nice man, Jack, doing all this for me. I'm scared.
No.
I mean, I feel so much for her. I feel like something awful's gonna happen.
Nothing awful is gonna happen.
No.
Anne is gonna be there. I'm gonna be there. Nothing awful's gonna happen. Okay?
I'm still scared.
I know. It's gonna be fine.
Okay. All right.
You're looking good.
You too.
Just remember to breathe. All
okay,
right?
I gotta breathe.
Big breath. It's Lydia Sinclair, a membership winner.
I know.
So what have you fellas been up to?
Well, everything's locked up downstairs. We thought we'd get some dinner.
Oh. Ow! Jack!
Say, anybody up for Chinese? Have you eaten? Would you like to join us?
No, thank you.
Watch your nails.
I'd rather go home.
Me too.
What did I tell you?
I know
it's only dinner.
You're gonna do this.
Look, you'll have something to tell your mother the next time she calls.
I don't give a flying.
You are coming. Fine.
I get to read the book sometimes, but mostly I calculate production costs from calculation costs from first edition hardcover to soft cover. Oh. And after soft cover, it's basically somebody else's problem. Then.
Boy, that sounds real exciting.
Honestly, it's not exciting at all.
Why not? Your calculations determine whether a book is published or not. It's a book that changes the way people think or, you know, act.
But what we publish is mostly trashy romance novels.
Don't say that. There's nothing trashy about romance. In romance, it's passion, it's imagination, it's beauty. Besides, you find some pretty wonderful things in the trash.
Dumplings. I could eat all of these.
What do you mean, like a dumpling? Some tea?
Yes, please.
There you go. All right.
Oh. Oh, boy. Sorry.
Help.
pages, huh?
What do you think?
Oh, it's good stuff, huh?
I think they were made for each other.
Thank you. No,
okay. Scary, but true.
Better off than in, huh? No, you got it? You got it? Oh, I got it. You got it. Queen of tattoos. On her back is the Battle of Waterloo. Beside it, the wreck of the Hesperus, too. And proudly above waves the red, white, and blue. You can learn a lot from Lydia. La la la, la la la, la la la, la la la. When her robe is unfurled, she will show you the world if you step up. And Delaware. For a dime you can see Kankakee or Perry or Washington crossing the Delaware. La la la, la la la, la la la, la la la. Oh Lydia, say have you met Lydia? Lydia the tattooed lady. When her muscles start relaxing, off the hill comes Michael Jackson.
No, come on. Did you see her with the noodles? No, she had a noodle hanging down her head for half the meal. I couldn't believe it. And then they started it on the top. They were playing hockey with the dumpling on the table.
It was broccoli.
Not broccoli. It was a dumpling. They were batting it around in the chat.
Oh, God, stop it. I'm going to lose it right here.
Burping.
Oh,
God.
Yo, Lydia. Watch out. Hey.
Tell me more about yourself. I'd like to know everything.
There's nothing more to tell.
Oh, don't say that.
No, is it?
It's enough for me.
I really think she went for him.
Oh, I know.
She
I
went for him.
I can't believe it. I can't believe I did it.
Amor vincit omnia.
What?
It's Latin. It means love conquers all. I don't mean us. I don't mean us. I mean everybody else.
God, you think it'll work out?
Who knows? Who knows? You know, two people could be at a party together, sitting right across from each other and never find each other. Another two people could be on opposite sides of the world. Nothing could keep them apart. Who knows? The thing is, if a thing is meant to happen, what?
Nothing. Come on.
Wait a minute. You must be very proud of yourself. You did a great thing for somebody tonight. I was very proud to be with you tonight.
You were great. Thank you. Dumplings. Mushu pork!
You don't have to say that.
I never say anything I have to.
No, I mean, you don't have to say nice things to me. a little old-fashioned considering what we're about to do.
What are we about to do?
You're walking me home.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're a little attracted to me.
Yeah?
And you'll probably want to come upstairs for some coffee.
I don't drink coffee.
And we'll probably have a drink and talk and get to know each other a little bit better, get comfortable. And then you'll... you'll sleep over. And in the morning, you'll awake. And you'll be distant. And you won't be able to stay for breakfast. Maybe just a cup of coffee.
I don't drink coffee.
And then we'll exchange phone numbers. And you'll leave. And never call. And I'll go to work and I'll feel so good for the first hour, and then ever so slowly I'll turn into a piece of dirt. I don't know why I'm putting myself through this. It was really nice to meet you.
Excuse me! Wait! Just... hey! Sorry. Wait, 1 minute. Hey, excuse me. Please, wait. Wait.
No, listen, I'm not feeling very well.
Oh, no wonder. We just met, made love, and broke up, all in the space of 30 seconds. And I don't remember having the first kiss, which I think is the best part.
Listen, it was so very special to meet you.
And it was for me, too. But I think it's time you should shut up now. Shut up. Please? I'm not coming up to your apartment. That was never my intention.
Oh, God, you don't want to.
Oh, no, I want to. I have a hard-on for you the size of Florida. But I don't want just one night. I have a confession I have to make to you.
You're married?
No.
You're divorced?
No.
You have a disease?
No, please stop. I'm in love with you. Not just from tonight. I've known you for a long time. I know that you come out from work at noon every day and you fight your way out that door and then you get pushed back in and 3 seconds later you come back out again. And I walk with you to lunch, and I know if it's a good day if you stop and get that romance novel at that bookstore. I know what you order, and I know on Wednesdays you go to that dim sum parlor, and I know that you get a jawbreaker before you go back into work. And I know you hate your job, and you don't have many friends, and I know sometimes you feel a little uncoordinated, and you don't feel as wonderful as everybody else, and feeling as alone and separate as you feel you are, and I love you. I love you. And I think you're the greatest thing since spice racks. And I've been knocked out several times. If I could just have that first kiss, and I won't be distant. I'll come back in the morning and I'll call you if you let me. But I still don't drink coffee. She didn't give me the number. This.
Feeling good. I don't know how else to put it, Lou. Yeah, well, I had those personal problems to work out, and I have, and now I want to get back to work. You think that's possible? Yeah, I understand. I am. Yeah. I won't. I will. Great, when? Tuesday's fine. Tuesday's great, Lou. All right, I'll see you then. Thanks a lot. Okay, bye.
Who's Lou?
Lou is my agent.
You're kidding.
I called my agent.
What did he say?
He says that if I want to get back to work, no problem. That I just come in and we talk and that's it. God, I gotta get these tapes organized. You see my jacket?
It's in the bathroom.
In the bathroom. I got the coffee here, if you want it.
You made coffee? You are going back to work and you made coffee? I'm loving this. Oh, you know what would be neat? How is this gonna be? Are there any coming in? I would love to look for a bigger place. I mean, you know, I don't want to rush anything, but I'd like to start looking anyway, you know? Maybe a two-bedroom, or maybe even top floor of a house. Say, in Brooklyn? Heights? What? You don't want to commute, right? That's all right. We could...
Come here. You are an incredible woman.
I'm an incredible woman?
Yeah.
What's this, a death sentence?
No, no, I'm gonna talk about this. So much has happened that I think it would be a good thing for both of us if we slowed down a little.
Slowed down? Where have I been? Have we been going fast
yet? Come on, Anne, now. Look, this has been a real, real difficult time for me this past year or so.
Yeah.
And, you know, I feel like I'm above water for the first time. I feel like I know a lot more now, and I don't want to make any more mistakes.
So?
I think I need time to make the right choices to,
Wait. I'm lost here. What are you saying?
Maybe I should be alone for a while. Now that I know more, you know, I feel that I should focus on my career now that I can, now that everything's taken care of. You know, Perry's...
All right, first of all, let me just say one thing, okay? You don't know shit, okay? Secondly, as far as we go, what have we been doing here except time? Have I ever pressured you once, ever?
No.
No. So what time do you need, baby? I love you. You love me. You want to get your career going? I think that's the greatest thing in the world. I want to be there when... I'm sorry. I want to be there when it happens. So what do you need time to figure out, huh? All right. Let me just ask you one thing. You love me?
I don't know.
You can't even give me that, can you? Jesus, Jack. What were you planning on doing here? Were you planning on just packing up your things, walking out the door and dropping me a note when you meet somebody new?
I had no idea what I was planning to do. I just said I need time.
Bullshit! If you're gonna hurt me now, not some long, drawn-out hurt that takes months of my life because you don't have the balls.
Okay, I'll pack my stuff tonight.
What have you been doing here? Could you just tell me that? What have you been doing here?
Hey, we both got something out of it, okay?
What did I get? What did I get? What did I get I couldn't have gotten from anybody with no name any night of the week? Do you think your company is such a treat? Your moods, your pain, your problems? Do you think this has been entertaining for me?
Then what do you want to stay with me for?
Because I love you. You stupid fucking...
Come here.
You don't get to be nice. I gotta play some stupid game with you where we act like we're friends so you get to walk out that door feeling good about yourself. I'm not a modern woman. If this is over, let's just call it over.
My wallet, what do you mean? Barry?
I can't hear you. I'm Dr. Mandeville. I was on duty when they brought him in. I've been going over his record. He was brought in once before, I understand. Catatonic stupor, condition rendered him nonverbal.
Yeah, so the guy, he's been beat up. He's got a concussion, right? He's gonna snap out of it.
I'm afraid not. See, the beating's bad, but it's not the problem. He seems to be re-experiencing the catatonia. So like before, he could snap out of it in an hour. Or 13 months. 13 years. There's no way to be sure. A person could actually re-experience the full effect of a tragedy long after the event took place. I was reading how he lost his wife. Are you relatives? Well, it doesn't matter. We'll take care of it. You'll have to be sent back to the same institution.
What if I was a relative?
Well, you'd have the option to care for him at home. But my advice is I wouldn't recommend it. It wouldn't be good for him. He needs hospital care. I just thought you could sign the release forms, but the city can do that. I'm sorry.
Poor Lydia. She finally finds her prince and he falls into a coma. Some women just have no luck, huh?
Damn. Answer, two dwarfs and a melon. Well, I'm out of here. Have a perfect weekend. And remember, on Monday's show, we have as our special studio guest, Ben Starr, star of the recently defunct hit TV show, On the Radio. So, from one of the botched to all of you bungled cats out there, I love you, and right back at you. Yeah. Yeah, Lou, look, I said I want an offer, they can forget it. Uh-huh. You tell them I'm talking to the cable people about a talk show. What? Beth's father set it up. No, he owns it.
Come on, you gotta move it.
Jack!
Come on, let's go. Come on.
Jack!
Look out. Hey.
No!
Jack, it's me!
Come on, now.
Stop it, I know that guy! Jack!
Let's get out of here.
Jack, you remember me?
Come on.
Venice! You know me, Jack! Jack, please, can I talk to you, please?
Let's come on.
Jack, I need to talk. Jack, we spent time together. Jack, please. Please, let me talk.
You know this guy?
Jack, please talk to me. Why won't you talk to me? Leave me alone.
It's a weekly comedy about the homeless. But it's not depressing in any way. We want to find a funny, upbeat way of bringing the issue of homelessness to television. So, we've got three wacky homeless characters. But they're wise. They're wacky and they're wise. And the hook is they love being homeless. They love the freedom, they love the adventure. It's all about the joy of living, not the bullshit that we have to deal with, the money, the politics. And the best part is, it's called Home Free.
Ooh, I'm getting a rush.
Oh, really? What is this, another disappearing act with this guy?
No, it's not a problem. It's a bathroom break. Took a bath. I'll check.
What? It's a grail. The Holy Grail.
The Holy... Some billionaire has got the Holy Grail in his library on Fifth Avenue.
My thoughts exactly. Who'd think he'd find anything divine on the Upper East Side? They said, you're the one.
They were lime colored, very nice, like this color here, with watermelons.
Oh, yes. I'm sorry. They're being cleaned. The doctor had a little accident with a hypo.
Well, that's all right. Just make sure that he does get them when they are clean. Thank you.
Jack. How you doing? You're looking good. You do. Hey. You gonna wake up for me? This isn't over, is it?
think you're gonna make me do this, don't you? Well, forget it. No fucking way. I don't feel responsible for you or for anybody. Everybody's got bad things that happen to them. I'm not God. I don't decide. People survive. Say something! Everything's been going great. Great. I'm gonna have my own cable talk show. Mm-hmm. With an incredible equity, I might add. I've got an incredibly fucking gorgeous girlfriend. I'm living an incredible fucking life. So don't lay there in your comfortable little coma and think I'm gonna risk all that because I feel responsible for you. I'm not responsible! I don't feel guilty. You've got it easy. I'm out there every day, every fucking day, trying to figure out what the hell I'm doing. Why, no matter what I have, it feels like I have nothing. So I don't feel sorry for you. It's easy being nuts. Try being me. So I won't do it. I don't believe in this shit. Don't give me that stuff about me being the one. There's nothing, nothing special about me. I control my own destiny, not some floating overweight fairies. I decide what I'm gonna do, and I'm not gonna risk my life to get some fucking cult for some fucking vegetable. Motherfucker, what am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do? Cup. Okay, all right, for sake of argument, let's say I do this, okay? If I do this, I want you to know it wouldn't be because I felt I had to, because I felt cursed or guilty or responsible or anything. If I do this, if I do this, it's because I want to do this for you. That's all. For you. Don't go anywhere. Horses now. Barry will be so pleased. Radio personality turned screwball on mission from God.
just hope when they put me away, they find me a place right next to his. Okay. Nobody looks up in this town. Christmas 1932. Oh! Wake up! my side of the bargain. Here's your cup. You gonna wake up now? You wanna think about it a little more. Okay. Take your time.
This dream, Jack. I was married to this beautiful woman. And you were there too. I really miss her, Jack. Is that okay? Can I miss her now? Thank you.
Here we go.
Oh, but what are you crying? Are you my girl? Huh? Are you my girl?
Yes.
Hey.
expect me to do? Apply? What? What'd you come here for? Did you come to get the rest of your stuff? There's no more stuff, Jack. It all got burned. Accidentally. Jack, don't do this. Whatever the hell it is you're doing, don't do it, okay? You don't just show up here out of nowhere and then stand there like a statue and make me do all the work. What did you come here for?
Love you.
What? I didn't get that. Would you run up by me again?
Doing that?
You crazy? It's the wind. I like New York in June. How about you?
I like a Gershwin tune. How about you?
Good night, Manhattan.
Say good night, Jack.
Good night, Jack.
Franklin Roosevelt's looks give me.